Christ. Shalom.
Shalom.
First and foremost, we want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh.
Hashem Yahushai. Hashem Lekakwadash.
I want to see apostles and elders and great men of God, our teachers and surely we will. Peace, love, blessings, and after all, we pour upon us in the earth. And doing this good gospel in all sins here again soon. Right, prophet back out here again. Come to prophesy. You don't fall this wicked kingdom.
Church.
Sleep, for now is our salvation nearer than when we believe.
That's it. Love will give you the temptation of God. I will return for the love of loving the most life, the heart, or the soul, or the mind, my children, that's it. And the other one, the second commandment, the love of God, I just say. When we come out here and preach this word, that's what we do, is showing love to these people.
That's right.
By giving them our warning.
God.
So if somebody love you, you could just see you fall, see you going into a pit, and then give you a warning and then fall. But that is not how we move in. We see the destruction coming, and we give them full warning and for them to take.
That's right.
So this scripture said, now it's high time to wake out of sleep. Sleeping meaning you've been drunk in these doctrines that are going to lead you into damnation. They are sleeping, now wake to the truth, now wake to the light, now wake to the fact that this kingdom can fall and that Lord's name is how and His name is how shine. Now wake to the fact that the kingdom of heaven is going to be again and that there's going to be a lot of destruction to be. But what is the scripture said, now it's high time to be talking, now it's the most. It's the best time to wake up to sleep.
That's right, right.
But we right at the door.
Time to the door.
Yeah, I'm trying to say, Matthew. He said, go preach. Go and preach, say, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And that was 2,000 years ago. You understand? So imagine how much more now in this time. Joel 2 and 1. Or Joel 1 and 2.
Huh? Joel chapter 2 and verse 1.
1 and 2.
1. Joel chapter 1 and verse 2. Hear this, ye old men, and give air to all inhabitants of the land.
And give air to all inhabitants of the land. Hear this, ye old men. It specifically say old men, because why? Because these people say that the end of the world happened since they was a child. So the scripture says, here they see old men and all the inhabitants of the land give air.
Yeah.
It's it.
Had this been in your days?
Had the microchip becoming mandatory was in your days? Were they building nuclear missiles in your days? You know, but if were homosexuality so rampant in your days? Was women above men in your days? No. These things are prophecies that were to be fulfilled in the end.
That's right.
They're trying to make you a sheep. When I say sheep, they want to implant a microchip in you and force you to do certain things. So basically, they wouldn't have a voice. Because all the information is going to be on that chip. All the financial information, the health information. So anytime you try to speak against them, what they will do, they will excommunicate.
Yeah, brother.
Yeah. No, they will stop you from being a citizen of the state by simply just taking you out of the society because your whole existence is on a chip. You understand? It come like if in this time, you don't have an ID card or you don't have a passport, you don't have a credit card. Go government, you can't do business.
Can't.
You know, because everything in metal, we need to have a former ID. So if they take off that chip now, if they say, well, you know, guess what, this one's weakened against us.
Yeah.
If they say this one's weakened against us, and they just took off your chip, you can't say Texas. You understand?
Understand, yeah.
You have cyanide also in the chip, which is a chemical in the chip that created a killer. And as you were saying that, you know, right now they're pushing, as soon as the ID card off, you know, they're pushing for a new ID card, which is like a RFID, you know? So whenever that person went for the ID card, they have a barcode to the back, which is like a baby step towards the original, what they're speaking about. They have a barcode to the back in a box form, and then on that, right there in Trinidad, I know I'm going to pull it going next side. Or else I'm going to put on some camera. You guys just have baby step towards what it is going to happen very soon.
That's right.
If you look at this movie, Upgrade, right? Or what was the end result of the movie? They had him in a delusion. So who knows where the chip will go in your head and in your hand. So the more they could have you in a delusion thinking you somewhere else and you're doing something totally different.
Can't.
Hey, they already had Jake in a delusion. They got a hard Jake thinking that.
Yeah, now started so like here for the camera up here. You know, but just attempting to show earlier the ID card that the brother was talking about, but yeah.
The new national identification card was established by registration rule 14. Look, when you hold the ID card up, you will see a 3D holographic image of an common bird and a hibiscus truly tilt. As you move your card in your hand, the card holder's date of birth becomes visible. Check. When you hold the card up, the UV light, the image of a hummingbird and hibiscus appear. And it's a barcode as well.
What's good? It's in the barcode, everything. That's not stuff, right?
A barcode. What barcode represents is that? What has been a barcode? It has three important lines in a barcode. So like, there are about 10 numbers, and I think the first one that's telling the item, and the second one, or the middle one that's telling who owns the item, and then the last one I think is what type of item it is. I can't remember exactly what barcode is. So that is showing that it's a product. Because if they have your ID card with a barcode and they can show you that it's a product.
Exactly.
That we tell people all the time. Yeah. That when they say, you gotta say, you have all in that region, I say, you already have all in that region. You gotta already have all the things that you're free. You understand? When actually you're not free. Because if you say, wake up one morning and say, no, I'm gonna go to Canada, you can't leave. You can't just pick up yourself and leave your show. Somebody in my Isaiah 65 verse 4.
As I wanted to mention earlier on too, concerning the barcode, right? And the driver's permit as well. We have the barcode behind the driver's permit already.
Yeah.
Alright? My license expiring next year. So eventually the next driver's permit I'm about to get. Might get, unfortunately it's still here, alright? I will receive one of them barcodes behind my driver's permit as well. Yeah, they don't already have it. You got one?
Yeah.
You got one?
Yeah.
Alright. Done.
Oh, and
so.
Like you take steps to one thing.
Done.
Yeah.
Okay, you do love this thing after I show you.
Done. Driver's license, natural and
Ja.
and you talking to Pharisees out there. Done.
Come on now.
Savage. It's Isaiah 65. It's Isaiah 65. Chapter 65 and verse 4, which he made among the evil before mine eyes, and choose that in which I delighted not.
Mosai said, you have chosen illusion. Then you damn it when I'm deep alive. But when it fall, when you're small knowledge, politically accept the truth. That goes straight back to when we was with Moses. You didn't even want to hear Moses. So guess what? I think you're gonna come back here and you're gonna believe the truth. You're so desired the truth, you're gonna receive the truth. You're not gonna receive the truth, you're gonna receive a lie. And let me most like call not three people now. And let me even have a show and walk on up and down. And even have any concern with what if you can have. And it? You don't know it, what would you realize in the future? That is something bad because all the information right on your bare head that you have open out on ourselves, that you think gonna protect me in that day.
A glass of water.
And a glass of water and probably a rose in it. All the information lies written within the Bible. But you don't know the future. That's a show how dumb people are. Ship blessings that we get. You have a Bible. That is the most important book in the world. And you're bent and you're not gonna take a read in it. So you're foolish. Understand?
Yeah.
But when we search the scriptures now and study the scriptures and come out here to preach and to teach people and to give people warning, they have a problem with us. All of a sudden you know the Bible now. All of a sudden you know the Bible. You want to give out opposition. This don't mean this and this don't mean that. But if you wait me, you don't know what it means. You can't go out and hold a post. You understand? And preach on your own.
But I was saying that, you know, the thing that the Bible opened on ourselves, because you see, is what actually does go on is that people think that the Bible in itself going to protect them. Is believing in the words going to manifest the angels of the Lord to protect you. The Bible within it physical form, just words lie down. They're not going to do nothing for you.
If they're saying these words, they are like them.
Can't. With the understanding.
Not like when you go close and you didn't get any manifestation.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, the scripture said, Yahushai said, he will leave us comfortless, so we are comfort in these words. You know?
Yeah, exactly.
We are comforting these words.
Yeah, because people have a concept that they go read our Psalms, right? Firstly, the name of the Lord is the key. In Revelation say that, behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man open, I will come in and sup with him and he with me. But in order to get the key to open that door, because everybody here in the door, the Heavenly Father knocking. But many of them don't know how to actually access to get to the other side of that door, to actually dwell in the sanctuary of the Heavenly Father. You have to get the name, you have to believe in the name, which is Yahushai, a Mashiach, not Jesus Christ or Allah or Buddha or Muhammad. It don't work like that.
That is exactly it.
Can.
Scripture say in Acts 4:12, Acts 1:21.
Acts 1:21.
axe one for one?
The book of Acts. Acts chapter 1 verse 21 reads, says, wherefore of these men which have Acts chapter 2 verse 21, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Whosoever shall call the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Or when? Take a time out it. This is Acts chapter 21. Acts chapter 1 verse 21. Acts chapter 2 verse 21. I said, it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Ye men of Israel.
Ye men of Israel. You understand? So it says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now we're going to read that. Because I'm going to read John 3:16. Because I'm going to read that. And think, well, whosoever in the world will call on the name of the Lord, which yet do not know, will not be saved. But we're going to say the next verse. Ye men of Israel, which are why? It applies to Israelites only. The word that John 3:16 spoke about is the word that Israel. And the Most High made an everlasting covenant with Israel. Everlasting covenant, a covenant forever, not going to change. You understand? And he said for covenant, when the stars and the sun fail, then Israel will no more be a people before me.
Man.
But let me see the sun still rising and setting, the moon still coming out, the stars still shining bright. So what I mean? We are still his people. Understand?
I'm a former
somebody give me down. Because you're gonna say that you know if they did a great song and the sun and the moon, right? Acts chapter 2 and verse 39, for the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are after afar off, even as many as the Lord of God shall call. And when they don't say afar off, it was supposed to say that you'll be broken and the promises were scattered. And who that promise was given to was Abraham, Isaac. Because the Lord specifically mentioned it in Genesis chapter 17, he said, in Isaac shall thy seed be called. Isaac shall thy seed be called, but because I read Hebrews
This is Hebrews chapter 8 and verse 8. It says, for fang and thorn for them.
So that is exactly
Hebrews chapter 6 and verse 13. It says, for when Yahweh made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swear by himself.
He swear by himself. Because the Most High, the ultimate power, as he said in Exodus chapter 3 and verse 14, right?
Verse 14. It says, saying, surely blessing, I will bless thee and multiply, I will multiply thee.
Who are you going to multiply? He said, I will multiply thy seed at the stars of the heavens. Alright? Because they tried to number Israel, but they can't number Israel. That is the promise that Moses have given. And when you go to Proverbs chapter 2, verse 21, as I've just read there. Alright? Ye men of Israel, this thing was given unto who? To Israel. The promise was given unto Israel. It wasn't given unto no other nation but Israel.
Since before the foundation of the earth was built.
What is this for? For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Yeah, there is their salvation in any other. So when the time comes that destruction taking place, if you call another God beside your house, shy, you're not going to be saved.
Sadly.
And that applies to Israelites only. We're eliminating all these other nations out of the equation one time because they are not the people of the Most High. You understand? It says, neither is there salvation in any other name
under the heaven whereby men must be saved. That is the name that we call upon now. So in the time to come, right, Proverbs 8:17. So in the time to come, when we call on that name, when we seek in salvation, the Lord gonna answer our prayers. You know, you can't curse on the Lord now. And then when destruction comes, you call upon the name of the Lord and expect to be saved. That is not just the name of God. Understand? Can you piece up that?
Proverbs 8 and verse 10. Proverbs 17. I love them that love me, and those that seek me early shall find me.
Yeah, those that seek me early shall find me. When it's early, before the storm comes, before the destruction takes place. Understand? Die when it's early. You're not done going when it's late, you're rushing like 10 foolish virgins. You know when the bride was on his way to the kitchen, go and get the oil, the lamb shrimp. They're not looking for that oil in that any time of the structure. They're looking for that oil now. Yeah. Those that seek me early shall find it.
Jumping down.
Jumping
down to verse 34. Blessed is the man that he hath me, watching daily at my gates, waiting at the post of my doors. For whosoever findeth me, findeth life.
For whosoever findeth him, findeth life. And how we're going to find it? But I was going to take it off. The key is the name. The key is the name. And if you don't have a name, go ahead.
And shall obtain favor of the Lord Yahweh. But he that sin against me wrong with his own soul.
Wrong with his own soul.
And all day that he hath me love death.
Love death. So all that deny the Lord, you know who see these men all the time is violence, bring all these scriptures. Alright? You all love death. Because when I'm talking about it, they are doom coming. They are doom coming. You know? This is Acts chapter 5, verse 21. And we from verse 20 says, the blood of our fathers raised up the house and whom he slay and hung on the tree.
Alright?
This is Acts chapter 5, verse 29. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than man. We ought to obey God rather than man. So when that time comes, and he shall come down with the heavy draconian laws, you know, we're going to rebel against him. As it was said in the scripture, you know, just as the holy apostles did. You know, it's sensitive for what they believe. Alright? God says, the blood of our fathers raised up the house like whom we slay and hung on a tree. And who did that? Matthew 27, verse 25, Baba Bosha. The ones that said, let his blood be upon us. And Matthew 26, 66. You were the one who said, he's guilty of death. Read the Matthew 26, 66. Well, Baba Bosha, and then read the Matthew 27, 25.
Yeah, right. Matthew 26 and 66.
Come.
What think ye? They answered and said, he is guilty of death.
But I said he's guilty of death. Anyway, that's the man, alright? To save the whole of Israel.
Go Barabbas, the Lego Barabbas.
Second Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 7. So that contrary wise, the old relic was put. It's First Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 7. But we speak the wisdom of Yahweh in a mystery. Corinthians 2 and verse 7, but we speak the wisdom of Yahweh in a mystery, even a hidden wisdom, which Yahweh ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
would not have crucified the Lord of glory if he had known it. Damnation was hidden from their eyes because he did not know the reason what was given. Because the scribes and the Pharisees, and the high priest, Zacharias, Zelachia, you know, the high priest, I forget his name, all right? His name right there, but I can't pronounce it properly. Caiaphas, Zelachia, if I'm mistaken, you know? Caiaphas, the high priest, Caiaphas, you know, they didn't want to come out of our sin. But John the Baptist, to what he humbly said, he said, I must descend and he must decrease. You know, and Tawara, they didn't want to come out of our sin. They don't want to give up that power because they know they were living a lavish life, thinking they were all righteous. But the most I knew there was evil because the rich was hidden from them. You know? Where are you? But, Salafia.
It says, what think ye? They answered and said, he is guilty of death.
Matthew chapter 27:25. It says, then answered all the people and said, his blood be on us and on our children.
Yeah, his blood be upon us and on our children. And this generation, he said, this generation shall not pass. This generation shall not pass. This is what we learn in Acts chapter 5. And verse 29, then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, go to a big God rather than man. The God of our fathers raised up Yahweh Shai, whom he slew, and hung on a tree. Then had Yahweh exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. That's what Yahweh Shai was sent to do, to be a prince and a savior unto the nation of Israel.
He's a prophet of Jehovah.
How you could ignore these scriptures? And you say you believe in the New Testament? Did you read what I read from Acts? Say you shall be a prince and a savior unto Israel. If you read that, you will understand why Matthew 1:21 say what you say. Luke chapter 1:6. All applies to him. Saving Israel. So then when I read to John 6, you know, I can see it. So what's it saying? This is actually deeper than I think it is. Understand? Because why all these other scriptures lead to one point? And then when I read this, saying something, say, nah, somebody wrong with that. Understand? But they don't do the research. They don't do the studies.
Connect the dots.
Done, yeah.
Listen, Isaiah.
You know what it does do? They just come up with a doctrine and select scriptures to fit a doctrine. Don't get a doctrine from the scriptures. That's a problem. That's in the heart that call to themselves teachers have a teaching head. Understand?
Isaiah chapter 44:21. Remember thee, O Jacob, and Israel, for thou art my servant, and I have formed thee. Thou art my servant, O Israel, thou shalt not be forgotten of me. But I was saying it earlier, you think about the poor of Israel and take up the other nation. Israel is his servant, even his firstborn.
That's right.
So I'm on the back track. This is Isaiah chapter 14:1. For Yahweh Hashem Yahusheh will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel. And I see this scripture saying will not give his glory unto another. In Luke 4, he says, give not what is profitable unto the unto a strange nation.
Done.
Understand?
That's why.
It says 2 Timothy chapter 3:7. It says, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Because he was now saying that, you know, that the Pharisees, you know, they always learn it, but they can't understand this if they read it, if they would have understand
John 1:21, Matthew 1:21. Understand Acts 3:21. You know, they would understand Revelation.